I'll say two things. Number one, I think he's one of the most important voices in America right now. He articulates our values maybe better than anybody else out there. Kerry Lake's kind of close, but Vivek does it amazing. Secondly, I'll say this, Gene, over the last two or three weeks, almost every conversation I've had about the presidential race, his name comes up before even DeSantis or anybody else. I get asked about him by almost everybody. They want to know what I think about him. You know, is he with us? Does he have our values? Is he the real deal? I've had the chance to meet him a couple of times at CNP, blown away by his presentations there. And I'm just so thankful for him. And what you were talking about at the beginning with the religious differences, obvious, but the religious similarities and the passion for freedom of religion and a recognition that there is a God. Remember what we've always said, the difference in the American system is that freedom comes from God and is exercised with respect for his authority. And Vivek shares that conviction with us. So I think he's a very important voice. And I would love to see him, if not in the White House, certainly in the administration, and a major player for helping us restore America.
It'd be a great time for me to eat some crow right here from what I said a couple of weeks ago about Vivek, because I mean, the Rolling Stone quoted me as gushing over him. I was like, oh, did I really gush? And I went back and watched it.
I kind of did.
It was awful. I was like, hey, and here's the thing. And by the way, kudos to Kuhneman, because you're right, brother. And I just want to say this. Why are we at a point in America where the church has done such a lousy job of raising up leaders that a Hindu articulates Christian principles better than any Christian candidate on the ballot? And why are we at a point where a Muslim, you know, a guy that treats women horribly by the name of Andrew Tate is now the hero to men and the guy that's most standing for manhood in America? Instead of having Christian godly manhood, you got millions of young men following this disgusting guy that has done incredibly disgusting things. Why are we at that point? Because the church has failed to raise up leaders. We failed to articulate the truth about our country. So my gushing was the fact that this guy, a Hindu, is actually saying what we believe. He's articulating our positions better than anybody else. And where I got it wrong was, and I went back and watched it, I said, either if not in the White House, on the team. What I meant was, I'd like to see him in the cabinet, not the actual president or vice president. I think he'd be a great secretary of commerce. So there's my crow. I was wrong in gushing, and I can't believe Rolling Stone used those words. But Hank is 100% right that we want Christian leaders. And the founder said that, right? The founder said it over and over again. You want leaders that are biblical leaders,